Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Gurur Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Sri Gurave When our mind interacts with the world with a question, why we are a samsari? And when our mind interacts with the world, who? Then we have taken a step on the spiritual path. When we say, why this is happening to me, why people are like that, why the government is like that, you are a solid samsari. Contrary to that, if you start your inquiry, who is miserable, who is disturbed, then the focus of your attention will be not on the extroverted area, but on your own self. Adhyatma means concern about one's evolution. And therefore, the teacher is telling to a dull-witted student. And who is the dull-witted student? His own wife. And therefore, instead of telling her in different ways, he started telling her in this way. Look here. Everything in this world, things and beings, possessions and relations, all of them are aimed at only ourselves. We don't like the things for them. We like the things for us. And in this manner, we have come to this conclusion. After many examples were given, sukha sadhanata annapanadaya priyaha. See, therefore, all the things such as the food, etc., they are liked by us, not for them, but for our own sake. Now, from here, some questions are raised. These are all the possible questions that we can entertain later period of time. You know what is one of the best things that I like in this Panchadashi? For the first time when I took this book for studies, many years before, 30-40 years before, that time what really attracted my mind was that all the possible doubts a human mind can entertain about the truth or about the spiritual practice, all of them are taken into account. At this moment we may not have any doubt, but as you start contemplation deeper and deeper, then many doubts start coming up. And therefore, if one studies this book, all possible doubts are taken care of, and then our knowledge becomes doubt-free. With the doubt-free knowledge alone, a conviction happens. And we are all living only our convictions. Today we are all convinced that we are body. Even if God comes and tells us, we will not listen to Him. Therefore, we have to make the knowledge into conviction. And for that, we have to study it deep. So, Atma Anukalya Annadi Samashchet Amunatrakaha Anukulaitavya Syat Naikasmin Karma Kartrutah. See, the self is dear to us because of the means of happiness, and such as like Annapanadi, like the food, etc. But you know, the self is not dear to us for something else. Food is dear to me, for me. My house is dear to me, for me. My relations are dear to me, for me. But I am dear for whom? I am dear for myself. So there cannot be two. Therefore, karma kartruta na ekasmin bhavati. For the same person, he cannot be the one who is liking himself and he is liked by himself. Because there cannot be duality in the self. And therefore, we are not the means of happiness to us, but we are the source of happiness to us. The basic difference. All other things are means. Food, shelter, friends, they are means. But the same thing cannot be both the doer and the done. Now, some of the mistaken understanding about the self are taken into account. Sukhe vaisheike priti matram atma tu adipriyaha sukhe vyabhicharet esha natmani vyabhicharini. Vaisheike sukhe, when we get comforts, joy from the worldly objects, then we have an ordinary love for that. But the self that we like is extremely dear to us. So two things. Things we like, no doubt. But we like ourselves the most, ati priyaha, because sukhe vibhicharati esha. These attraction towards the worldly objects which give us happiness, vibhicharati, is never the same. Right from childhood, if we analyze our own life, what we were so much mad after the things, as the age changes, our priorities, our liking, our everything keeps on changing, because the same thing cannot give us eternal happiness for all the time. And therefore, the love for the self is the extreme love. We never feel that I don't like myself, whatever we may be. See, friends, therefore, sukhe vibhicharati esha na atmani vibhicharani. One is never the feel that now I don't like myself. And those who say, I don't like myself, they are talking about the self as the body. Those who say that I want to commit suicide, I am fed up. So that suicide is committed for our own self, not for the sake of the body. Because the body is not a problem. Identification with the body creates all the problem. Friend, this is one of the most important things we have to understand. Spiritual life has only two stations. Then we reach the ultimate. First is freedom from body identification. Second one is freedom from the notion that we are a soul inside the body. This is called as viparita buddhi. Viparita buddhi is what? When we go to the jeweler and see some ornament, we ask him a question. Hey, is there gold in this ornament or it's only plastic? So, what is our understanding? There is gold in the ornament. Another example I had given number of times. Once I was going by cruise somewhere with my friend, and he asked me, can you imagine, Swamiji, how much water must be deep in the ocean here? I said, I don't answer wrong questions. There is no water in the ocean, but the ocean is in the water. He said, please don't bring your Vedanta. Exactly the same way, we are not in the body. The body is in us. If you want to get it right now, whole attitude will change. See? When we take this glass has two things. One is the space inside the glass, and second is the water. When I move this glass, the water moves along with the glass. But is the space moving along with the glass? What is the reason? Because we may say that there is a space in the glass. What is the truth? The truth is the glass is in the space. Now, most subjective experience. Work on this. You are seeing me. I can't see you are hearing me. You are seeing me. Now, where are you seeing me? Outside or inside? inside. But I am outside. So unless I am included in your mind, you cannot see me. So the mind is outside also, and the mind is inside also. Like the space is outside the glass and inside the glass. Therefore, what is the conclusion? The glass is in the space in the same manner. The body is in the mind. Now, where your body has gone, find out. So when the glass breaks, will the space from the glass will go out? Exactly. When the body dies, perishes, will the mind, the soul, go out of the body? There is no soul, one per body. You have to completely change your whole understanding. The body is in me. I am not in the body. See, friends. Therefore, one has to go deep into our own experiences. So here, Sukhe Vaishayike Priti Matram Atmatu Ati Priyaha. We remain in our room, in our house. So much expensive, spending money in crores. But ultimately, when we are really happy, when we come in open space near the ocean, it is so nice. Because now you have gone out of the cocoon of your small little existence. Exactly the same way, when we break the barrier of individuality and merge in the totality, the experience is divine. And therefore, the love that we have for our own self is extreme. Ekam tyatvanyada datte sukham vaishayikam sada natma tyajyo na chade deha tasmin vivicharet katam. Ekam tyatva anya adatte sukham vaishayikam sada. In case of one object you enjoy, you get some better option. Then you leave that object, you get a second object. Then you get third object, you leave the second object, you go for the third object. In case of the objects, or the things, or the beings, there is an option of rejection and acceptance. I don't like it. This is how the divorces happen. They get married because they like. Then they realize their mistake and they correct their mistake. And then again they go with a fishing rod in search of something else. This is possible because that can be rejected and that can be gained. But when it comes to your own self, you cannot reject yourself. You can never have the experience of your own absence. Because we cannot reject ourselves, we don't have to gain ourselves. Aheyam, that which cannot be rejected. Anupadeyam, and therefore that need not be gained. Therefore, there is nothing like seeking self, but it is discover the self. Who you are? Are you mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife? Are you body? Are you Indian? Are you American? Gujarati? Bengali? What is your real nature? See, when I go to USA, I change my citizenship. Once I wrote a small story about Gujaratis. Every Gujarati, I don't know why, but they are born in Navsari. And in Navsari, they are not happy. So they go to Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad, they are not feeling fulfilled. They come to Mumbai. A Gujarati never comes to Bombay. He comes to Mumbai. Now Maharashtrians have started calling Mumbai. Gujaratis always called it as Mumbai. They come to Mumbai. After coming to Mumbai, do you think they are happy? No. They want to go to USA. Then they go to USA. Then the first thing, struggle hard, work hard. Nobody can beat the hard-working capacity of the Gujaratis. They work hard. And then they get their green card. Are they satisfied? No. They continue working hard. And one way or the other, they get the citizenship. And thereafter, they have already reached 65. Then they say, our Navsari is good. And they come back to Navsari. Purnamadaha, Purnamidam, Purnar, Purnamidam. So whether you are a Gujarati or Indian or American, what are you? You can keep on changing your citizenship, your relations, your things around you. You cannot change yourself. You are ever the same. You are not doing anything. No asana, no pranayama, no charity, no chanting the japa. Just correct your focal length. Like we go to the eye doctor. What the eye doctors do? They don't give us vision. They help us. Our accommodation of the eyes, we can have proper focal length. We are also eye doctors. But our spelling of I is different. The eye doctor spelling is E-Y-E. Our spelling is iPhone, iPad, everything I. Change this I's focus. Instead of mother, father, disciple, guru, instead of all this rubbish, focus on that. Aheyam anupadeyam. That which can never be rejected. That is the self. Therefore, there is no possibility of any option. Hana dana vihinesmin upeksha che trunadivat upekshitu swarupatva nupekshatvam nijatmana. Hana dana vihine. That which cannot be given up or accepted, hana is to give up, adana is to take up. Vihine without that. Then, asmin in our absolute said, truna adivat, like the grass or anything, upeksha chet, if one imagines to be totally indifferent, then the question is, the one who is indifferent is his own nature. Be attentive. Every time you just try to work out every statement, it will take you back to yourself. I am seeing you all. I see the green color with my eyes. Then I shift to the red color. The moment I go to the red color, I am indifferent to the green color. From the green red color, I come to the dark blue color. Then I am indifferent to the red color. In short, remaining indifferent is our essential nature. Attachment is an illusion. Are we not indifferent to our childhood? Come on, gone. The teenage has gone. The middle age has gone. We are expert in dying 3 times so far. Why should we be afraid 4th time? Are we not indifferent to our own body, pain or joy when we go to sleep? See friends, therefore indifference is our essential nature. Follow that up. You will not get entangled in this world. Shatru mitre putre bandhau mahakuru yatnam vigrahasandhau. Don't create friends and enemies in this world. Therefore, upekshati sarupada nopekshatam nijatmana. But we cannot remain indifferent to ourselves. Because we are ourselves. Who will be indifferent to himself? Cannot be. I can be indifferent to my pain. I can be indifferent to my achievement. I can be indifferent to my enemies. But I cannot be indifferent to myself because I am me. And therefore, continuing further, roga krodha vibhutana mumusha vikshate kvachit te tato dveshad bhavityajaha atmeti yadi tannahi. Now tell that roga krodha abhibhutanam, those who are influenced by or affected by the anger or the diseases, etc., they desire death. They mumursha vikshate kvachit. We see that these people are all the time thinking of, it is better that I must die, I must give up. Because dveshat bhavityajaha, because they hate the unhealthy body. They hate somebody. And therefore, if I can't, then I commit suicide. And in this manner, their indifference is worthy of rejection of the body, etc. And therefore, if you doubt that we can also, those who commit suicide, they are fed up of themselves. No, they are not fed up of themselves. It is the same wrong notion. Those who want to live long and those who want to commit suicide, both of them have the same illusion. And I am the body. Therefore, yesterday I made it very clear. Healthy body and long life cannot be the goal of life. A wonderful car to own, that cannot be the goal of life. I was in South Africa, in Port Elizabeth, and just on the seaside, most beautiful place, a nice building, and one couple was staying there. So I went to see them, elderly people, only two of them, and both of them so frustrated, dejected. When I went and look at their face, as if they are consumed, handful of caterpillars. So they said, Swamiji, how long do we have to live in this world? Such a beautiful house on the seaside. I said, what is wrong? Everything is fine. No pain, you know, and we feel lonely. Our children, they don't come to us. We have created this house only for them, but nobody wants to come here. See, friends, people become miserable, disgusted, not about themselves, about the world. And therefore, it is said, Tyaktum yogasya dehasya natmata tyakturevasa na tyaktirasti sadvesha tyaje dveshu kutte dveshe dukakchati. Tyaktum yogasya dehasya. The body is worthy of giving up. Atmata tyaktuhu eva. Therefore, the one who wants to commit suicide, he has to be other than the body. I want to give up this paper. I give up this paper. Because the paper is other than me. I cannot give up myself. Wherever we go, there we are. Where we will run away. And this is what most of us do. We run away from ourselves. Either having the birds in the ears and constantly dancing, or watching the TV or the mobile phone, the WhatsApp infection, constantly running away. Because we are fed up of ourselves. Because I am man, I am young, I am old, I am husband, I am wife, and this is how we keep on running. And yet, wherever you go, there you are. You cannot run away from yourself. Therefore, na tyakti rasti sa dveshaha tyajye dveshe dukakshati. Therefore, he doesn't hate himself. He hates himself as a husband. He hates himself as a wife. There was one girl, she asked me this question. Swamiji, not girl, a lady. Swamiji, two of us are staying under the same roof, but we are not in talking terms. I cook the food is kept, he comes and eats. What is this life? I feel I should get divorced. Then I told her in Hindi, Akash se tapke, khajur pe latke. I said, what are you going to do? You are trying to create an optional problem. You are not trying to solve the problem. Then I said, have patience. Don't have bitterness. Forget about all your past, good or bad. And give time to yourself and to him. And some event will happen in your life. And you will again come back. God willing, within 2 years, again they started as if nothing had happened in the past. Then who was miserable? Husband and the wife. Not themselves. Therefore, we have to again and again bring to our notice who is happy, who is miserable. The one who is conditioned is happy or miserable, and he is worthy of rejection. Na tyakti rasti sa dvesha tyajye dveshe dukakshati. So whatever can be rejected, reject it. So don't reject the husband by divorce, but try to know first, you are a man, you became a husband. You are a woman, you became a wife. They are not real. What is real is you, the man. In the same manner, when we come to the body problems, then we are not the body, the one who is embodied. In this manner, slowly become self-oriented in analyzing your experiences. Those who can analyze their experiences in the light of wisdom, they will very clearly understand. In this world, friends, enemies, dear, near, etc., these are only operational modes, but the truth is beyond all of them. Hey friends, you must have seen when some old people, one of them dies, suppose the husband dies first. The smart one always dies first. The dumb remains behind. And then you watch their dialogues. That lady, she will never talk one word about him. Oh, he has gone suddenly like that. Now what will happen to me? Now how can I do? I have never done this thing. He is dead. He is no concern. Concern is about me. Because atmanastu kamaya sarvam priyam bhavati. Everything is dear to us for ourselves. One day, it happened in Bombay only. One young police officer, very good friend of mine. He has a wife, two daughters and a son. And the daughter was in college, medical college. And son was, I think, class 10th or 12th. And the youngest daughter was very small, 5-6 years. And police officer was also not very old. He was in his mid-40s or late-40s. One day he came from whatever place in the morning, 4 o'clock, his own house. Before he could ring the bell, he fell down on the floor outside the house and died on the spot. Morning walkers, when they saw somebody properly dressed, what happened? They saw they immediately called, and the wife and everybody came, and all commotion happened. So, when it happened, I went to meet them, and then the son was so miserable and all that, and he started shouting at God, "I'll throw on the gods. Swamiji, my dad was so much devoted to you. How do you allow me to die?" And after some time, then, see, now how we'll live? Mummy doesn't know anything. My sister is yet to study. I am hardly in 10th, 12th standard. Younger sister, how can we live now without him? Slowly he was talking. I said, "Now I won't talk to you. I am in a hurry. I'll come again." After 2 months again I went. I said, "Now you talk." He says, "Swamiji, I am sorry, that time I behaved very bad with you. But you know, the problem is, now how are we going to live?" Then I said, "Now have you observed what you are talking? You are not talking one word about your father. You are talking about yourself." See, friends, he was just a source, a means to give you comforts. This is the truth of life. Then I told him, I said, "If you change your thinking, you will be never miserable." "Now what I have to change?" I said, "Just imagine. Your father was transferred to the chief of the security of the president of India. From Bombay he is transferred there. Will you be miserable or happy?" "Of course I will be happy. Because he got promotion." In the same manner, now he is promoted from this wretched life. He is growing spiritually. What is wrong in that? And what will be the image you will have about your father? A young, dynamic man, before even 50s, he was my father. Can you think about your father bedridden, and all the tubes, and pathetically in coma, and everybody is praying, "Oh Lord, Bhagwan inko uthao, inke kashta deke nahi jate, kashta unko nahi hote, pay karne wale." See, friends, what type of image you will like to have? Image of a father who was dynamic, young, or dilapidated and not dying? This I never thought. I said, "Yes, you correct your thinking. 99% of the problems are dissolved. They don't need to be solved. All the problems are because of wrong thinking. Correct your thinking. And it is for this purpose we are studying." So, "Tyaktum yogasya dehasya natmata tyaktu revasa. Na tyaktirasti sa dvesha tyajye dveshi tu kakshate." Then, "Atma tattvena sarvasya pritishit atma yati priya siddho yata putra mitrat putra piretarastata." He gives the example. "Atma tattvena sarvasya pritishya atma ati priya." The self is extremely dear to us than any other things. Example is given. Like siddho yata putra mitrat putra priyataraha. I like my son more than my son's friend. See? So, I like my son more. My son's friend, he is a good boy. But liking is concerned, my son. So, priyatara, comparatively superior. Come from the son to yourself. When the child is doing very well and he is bringing glorious awards, then the father starts gloating, "Oh, my son." And if the father, the son, he is a terrible monster, creating problem for everybody in the family and outside, then, like a Hindi cinema dialogue, "Tu mere liye mar gaya, main tere liye man gaya." I don't own you. Why? Because he is no more a source of happiness. Therefore, these are the things to be fully convinced by us. that we love ourselves the most because we are the source of absolute happiness. What happiness we get from the world, things and beings, is only borrowed happiness. What is the difference between borrowed happiness and actual happiness? The sweetmeat, rasgulla, borrows sweet from the sugar. But the sugar doesn't borrow sweet. It is its own nature. See, friends, in the same manner, we are all borrowing happiness from the worldly things and beings. And if the same thing comes out to be a source of disturbance, immediately we reject. See, friends, therefore, all our attempts in our day-to-day life should be aware of your blissful self. Make this a firm resolution for the new year. May what happen, refuse to be miserable. This is not a Patanjali's yoga, Krishna's yoga. Bhagavan Krishna's yoga is Tam vidya dukkha sa yoga viyogam yoga sanditam sa nishchena yoktavyaha yogaha anirvinna chetasa. When the miseries come in our life, we refuse to be miserable. This ability to refuse to be miserable is called the yoga. Doing some asana, doing some pranayama, or doing some puja poti, these are okay. Nothing wrong in that. But the ultimate is this. And this is exactly told by Patanjali, but we bypass that. When Patanjali says, Tada drashtu sarupe avasthanam, the seeker, the yogi, comes back to his divine nature. What is the divine nature? All bliss. So instead of doing a Dravidi pranayam, you know, pranayam is done normally this way. But Dravidi pranayam, South Indian pranayam, you put in the no, don't do that complicated things. Simple way, be happy. What we are doing? We are becoming happy. If I get something, I will become happy. If I don't get something, I become miserable. And thus our life is undulating up and down with joy and sorrows. Therefore, yatha putra mitra putra piratara statha. Then, the further thought is taken. Mana bhuvam aham kintu bhuyasam sarvadetyasau ashi sarvasya drishteti pratyaksha pritiratmani. Now, how we love ourselves the most? Now, this is established here. Mana bhuvam aham, may I not cease to exist? And bhuyasam sarvada, and let me be always be. And therefore what we do? It is a great fun if you catch it. One day there was one journalist, a girl in Dehradun. She came to take my interview and gave me a big paper and questions. He said, these are the questions for you. You can study them and I come in the evening and then you can reply. I threw the paper on her. I said, take it away. I don't read it second time. Are you ready now? I said, are you ready? Yes. She started asking one by one question. Afterwards, she became frustrated. Will you answer a single question straight? I said, I answer the questions according to the quality of the questions. Okay, last question. I said, okay, last question. Her last question was, how do you like to leave your footprints in this world when you leave this world? Then I told her, first of all, you will not be there to see my footprints because you are going to die before I die.
She became so frustrated.
Then I told her, I said, look here, those who walk in the mud, they leave the footprints. The birds fly, they don't leave any footprints anywhere. Those who are matter-oriented, they want their name and fame. This is Bhagwan's Maya. And this Maya you all have seen in Uttar Pradesh, making one's own statue. See, Maya is absolute Maya. See, making one's own statue and then putting the garland and doing the aarti. We all have this notion, and these notions are the samsara. Name and the form, this is samsara. Forms are outside, name is in our mind. Give your mind absolute silence and absolute formlessness as the objects of contemplation. Your mind will dissolve in consciousness. Because mind and consciousness are one and the same, like the ice and the water are one and the same. Water with the shape is ice. Ice without shape is the water. Consciousness with the predominance of names and forms is mind. Mind without the names and the forms is consciousness. Friends, this is uncomfortable to feel, but this is the truth. See how we are cheated by ourselves the most. Once I went to Vrindavan, some place, the Panditji, some place where Bhagavan Krishna did some leela, we went there to take darshan. And a Panditji there, he told, Maharaj, you kindly fix one stone in your name. And see, so many people have fixed stones. Okay, fix. He said, it will cost you 2100 rupees. I said, never mind, you can pay. No, you have to pay. I said, I don't pay anything. I only receive money. That is why I don't open the account in a Lena bank. Only Lena bank. No Lena bank. Then he said, see, you know what is the importance of this? I said, I don't know. Importance is, when anybody will come and step on the stone where your name is written, all his merits will be transferred to you through Bluetooth. See? Now see the fun. The stone doesn't know whose name is that. The artist who made the name, he doesn't know. And the person who is stepping on the stone, he doesn't know. And after you die, you also do not know. Can there be more foolishness? Let my name remain immortal. This whole world is not real. And in that you keep the name immortal. Wow. See friends, I'll give you some difficult task. It will shake you totally. Either write autobiography of a dreamer, or don't write the autobiography of a waker. Can you write autobiography of a dreamer? In one dream I was poor, in the second dream I was rich, in the third dream I was miserable. Nobody writes, because dreams and dreamers are illusions, and every dream has a separate dreamer. It is not the same dreamer. If this is for the dream, it is 100% equally so for the waking also. Every waking experience has a separate waker. But the substratum supporting all the vehicles is neither awake nor sleeping, nor dreaming. That is our essential nature. So many dreams have come and gone. So many waking experiences come and gone. What happened to us? Observe this day-to-day life. We have no experience of birth, growth, death and absence. It is the grace of the people around, they remind us. For the first time when a girl is addressed by a child, "Auntie, you please sit here." That time that girl gets a first shock. "Don't call me auntie, I am Didi." The second shock we get in life, when a few days before, one mother came with her child. And she came and the child, she wanted to tell, "Beta, look, 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 Dadaji is here, talk to him." That time I realized I am old, Dadaji. Otherwise, you don't get the experience that you are growing. Recognize this. But we don't want to grow. So what do? We do the beauty parlor treatment. A WhatsApp. You can fix anything in WhatsApp. If you want to keep your hair black, stop growing them white. Take raw vegetables, 25% of your diet, take 30% of the boiled vegetables and avoid the milk, the maida, sugar, salt and line. Then after every 15 days color your hair. What for? The grace of the old age is so lovely. But above the neck, it is sweet 16. Below the neck, it is 81 not out, hanging like a coat on a hanger. See, friends, the day you discover this, that all changes are happening around me, not to me. One old man in some place asked me, "Where are you from, Maharaj?" I said, "I am from Vrindavan." Seeing the atmosphere there, I knew they are Krishna brand, so I said, "Vrindavan. You must know when to tell what." So I said, "From Vrindavan." "Oh, you are from Vrindavan?" "Yes." "Vrindavan has changed so much in last 40 years, isn't it?" I said, "Babaji, come." I took him near the sink where you wash hands. A beautiful mirror. I said, "Look into the mirror. 40 years before, is it the same fellow?" When you talk, Vrindavan has changed. Have you not changed? When we make this statement, Vrindavan has changed, we are not aware who is talking. It is not the old man who is talking. It is the substratum who is observing all the changes without undergoing any change. This is our essential nature. Therefore, manabhubam aham kintu bhuyasam sarvada asau. This is again and again to emphasize in our own experience. Nobody wants his own absence and nobody wants to die, wants to be eternally present. In Bhagavad Mahapuran, a story comes. That of the Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu was killed by Bhagavan Varaha, and after he was killed, naturally his wife started crying and miserable. So Hiranyakashipu, her brother-in-law, went and spoke to her and tried to pacify her. "Look here, sister-in-law, this is how the world is. anybody who is born has to die, nobody is here eternal, and all the blah blah Vedanta, her misery went away. She became okay. But then he got in trouble. Oh God, that means I have to also die. No, I don't want to die. And then he did tapasya, Brahmaji came, and he said, I don't want to die. He said, it's not possible. Any other option? Plan B. He said, okay, I don't want to die on the earth. I don't want to die in the sky. I don't want to be killed by the instruments. I don't want to be killed by animals or human beings. So many things. Not in the day, not in the night, not inside, outside. The Brahmaji is super. He said, never mind. He manufactured a new robo. And Narasimha Rao Garu came. And then that Hiranyakashipu was killed. See, friends, all this story tells us our whole life is lived by the body, for the body, on everybody. We have to again and again remind ourselves, live a comfortable, cheerful, jolly life, no doubt about it. But at the same time, base should be this. See? Otherwise, we are destroying ourselves. Ashi sarvasya drushteti pratyaksha priti ratmane. And why this is done? That I should not die and I should be eternally present because I love myself the most. See? If there is something wrong with my small finger, and in the interest of the total, I will like to cut it. If there is something wrong with my hand or the palm, then in the interest of the total hand, I will chop it off. See? Because I love myself the most. And therefore, ityadi vistribi prito siddhayam eva matmani putra bharyadi visheshatvam atmana kaiche iridam. In this manner, these are the three trivi, these are the three ways we are trying to establish this truth that we love ourselves the most. Which are the three things? First, authority of the scriptures. Two, logically accepting what is said in the scriptures. And third, analyzing our own experience. Shruti, Yukti and Anubhuti. When these three things are properly applied, we come to this conclusion that really we have to be someone in whom the whole world is. In our Prempuri ashram, one day, I don't see that old man now. So he asked this question. Swamiji, you should not go out of Bombay. I said, okay, I will not go. These are principles, try to catch it. If any old person never argue, whatever they say, without listening, you say yes. Next time they will forget yes about what. So you are saved. If you discuss, then there will be a problem. So I said, yes. Then he said, these days I am having a fear that if I die, what will happen to my wife, my children, my property? If I am not there, my wife has no existence. If I am not there, my property has no existence. Everything is in this I. But the problem is, who is this I? This has to be properly sorted out. Otherwise, sasyamiva martyaha pachyate, sasyamiva jayate punaha. Like the grass we grow, like the grass we perish. So many are born and gone. Like that in that whole lot, we are also coming and going. Is that life? This is the last opportunity for all of us. In this very life, we must be an instrument through which the truth is revealed to the world. You don't have to see God. He has to express through us. An expression of God is only one, happiness. Therefore, this is ityadibhi stribhi prito siddhayam evam atmane putra bharyadi sheshatvam atmanah kaschid iritam. Although this is so, yet there are some people who tell, no. Actually, the self is not the atma, but the self is the husband, the wife or the children. That is what it is. Therefore, what you are telling, it is not true. How? Etad vivakshaya putre mukhyatmatvam shruti iritam atma vai putra nameti tachopanishad is putam. It is said now, it is told from me at the Upanishad that atma vai putra nama iti. It is said the self is none other than the son. And therefore, the self is not the self what you are telling, but the son is the real atma, the real self. And the thought continues. So asya ayam atma punyebhya karmebhya pratidhiyate atha asya itara atma ayam krita krutya prameyate. So then what happens? It is said that his father, when the son is his real self and therefore he is authorized, punyebhya karmebhya pratidhiyate means pratinidhi, he is authorized for all the activities what the father was supposed to do. Now my son will take over. My son is a very nice person. He will take care of everything. And thus the son is the atma and not the man or the self is the atma. And therefore at the time of departure, this is the only thing the father tells the son. Now you take over. You are the one who will hold the reins of this family, and in this manner I am going. Therefore, the son is the atma and not the man. Tatyapyatmani lokosti na putra se evahi anushtitam putra meva lokyam ahru maneshina. And it is also said, those who do not have the son, they do not get the heavens, etc. And therefore, now, O my dear son, you are there, now I will be going to the heaven and therefore I shall instruct you what you have to do. So, manushya loko jayasyat putrena eva itarenyano mumurshur mantra yed putram tvam brahma iti adhi mantra kaihi. So, manushya loka jayasyat. In the worldly things also we know, all the property, everything is normally given to the son and a daughter may get, may not get. Because the son is the representative of the father and not the daughter. And therefore, at the time of death, the father tells the son that now you take over and I tell you that you are Brahman and think about that in this manner. Ityadi shrutaya prahu putra bharyadi sheshatam laukika api putrasya pradhanam anumanvate. Therefore, the scriptures also tell that the son, the wife, etc., they are the helpful and in the worldly things also. Therefore, the son, wife, etc., they are the real atma and not the man. Swasmin murtepi putradir jived vitta dinayata yatai vayatna kurute mukhya putradayastata. And even at the time of death, the father is always thinking that if I die, who will take care of my son? Therefore, he keeps all the money, wealth and only thing for the sake of the son. And therefore, the real atma is not himself, but the son is the real atma. So what was the discussion in these 4-5 verses? This, that you are not the absolute reality, your son is the reality. He is taking care of everything. Whenever you go, you die and go, but he is still there. Therefore, we don't accept that the conscious, blissful self is the atma, but the son or wife, they are the real atma. Now, from here, the teacher takes up a very beautiful approach. Badham etavata natma shesho bhavati kasyachit gauna mithya mukhya vedahi atma ayam bhavati tridha. From here onward, the real meaning of the atma, the self, is indicated. The first is, he accepted, yes, what you said is true, but that is not the real Atma. Oh, there are unreal Atma, yes. Then there are three types of Atma. Now, which are those three types of Atma and which is our real self? This is the main theme that we will try to understand, and then we come to know that the real self is the one who is the source of all happiness. And he who is thus abiding in this absolute real self, he will have never any problem in his life. Problems will come, but he will not become miserable. Many of us have got this notion, if I am studying scriptures, if I am going to satsang, etc., then I should not have problems. This is wrong. It is like this. I have got an international driving license. So when I am driving the car, there should not be bad traffic on the road. If you have a driving license, you should have the ability to negotiate through the difficult traffic. The traffic will not change. In the same manner, if we are walking the spiritual path, we will change. Things around will remain ever the same. Don't have the wrong notion that if you die happily, you are happy. No, no, no. It doesn't matter because you have already discarded the body long back. See, in Bhagavad Mahapuran, at the end it comes. After having heard the whole Bhagavad, and a snake came and bitten him and Parikshit died. Now the question comes, after listening to that, if the snake has to come and bite, what is the use? The use is different. We have not understood it. Before the snake could come and bite him, he has himself disowned the body. I cannot be the body. So it is like killing the killed. See, friends, therefore, one has to recognize what exactly we mean by I. And when this is clearly understood, then you will see you don't need to solve any problem. All the problems get dissolved. So which are the three types of Atmas? That is a very beautiful topic. And take it in our tomorrow's class. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnahat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.